I've never really put down any great efforts in the gym when it comes down to one certain exercise. And that exercise is the barbell row. Rows has never actually been my thing, or training back in greater range for that matter. For a long time, I thought that the barbell row has been overrated, but when I think back to it, I don't know why. Why is that? Why do I think like this? Because it's not, is it? I mean, if I had to choose one muscle part on my body that I feel like I put down the least time on, it's my back. And yet, my back is one of my best muscle parts according to myself, especially when it comes down to visual progression. But this is it. I've trained back when I did more bodybuilding approach and still is incorporating a lot of dumbbell row variations, supersets, and even unilateral rows. But when it comes down to strength in my back, I really never did it. And obviously, I've been practicing and put down a lot of time on my lower back with movements like the deadlift, Romanian deadlifts, and even hyperextensions too recently. But now I'm referring more to my upper back. I very occasionally, but very seldom, train my upper back strength. Like I said, I spent time on sculpting the back with hypertrophy work, but never really with the heavier and lower rep work. It's something that I really haven't been reflecting on because I put down more work on the lower back. My lower back has too been lacking a lot, but the past year, or almost years, I started to really focus more on this as well, which has given me a lot of tools and strengths to my lifts in general. Something that really made me think about this was an article I read the other day that stated a recommendation that you should be able to row 50% of your deadlift max. Wait for it. 4, 8 repetitions. Are you kidding me? 8 reps? I mean, for me, that means I would be able to row 120 kg for 8 reps, and to be honest, that makes me laugh so hard because that isn't even close right now. It's so far away. And I also have been starting to reflect upon my internal rotation in my shoulders as well, which is creating a small forward hunch in my upper back. Yeah, it's a lot of mobility issues as well that is creating this, but it's not all, is it? It's also due to some upper back weaknesses too, is it not? I mean, not as a big part, but still an underlying factor, if you ask me. Increasing my strength in my upper back wouldn't only give me a stronger back and posture in general, but especially, it would add a lot to lifts like the overhead press, squat, deadlift, and yes, the bench as well. I've actually tried to do some barbell rows in the past, but really never stick to them, you know? And like I mentioned, I do rows on a daily basis almost, but this revolves around mostly high rep work with either cables or dumbbells. So I thought now I'm gonna start implementing more barbell rows, especially heavy barbell rows. I'm gonna really try because heavy barbell rows is really one lift that I've practiced with very little duration. And this next block will focus a lot on my back strength in general, both lower back, upper back, and core. So I thought, why not practice heavy rows? Why not? Like I said, I never really stick to them. haven't practiced them consistently, but that's because I really never thought I needed them that much, or that I really didn't feel the mind-muscle connection as much in the barbell row as in the, let's say, dumbbell variations. And that's true too, is it not? And the past few months I've been focusing more on hypertrophy and less on strength anyways, but now I'm gonna switch back to the more strength-based approach. I mean, take the squat. My squat has evolved a lot during the past year, and I feel like it's only the beginning of a big squat. It takes time, but I really got something going on here. But one weakness in my squat has recently been my forward lean, which I have improved with a lot of core work, a lot of lower back work, but now remains the last piece of the puzzle. The upper back strength and stability. And the upper back. This is where it all comes down to, like I said, the stability. My core, my lower back has improved a lot, both in stability and strength. But if my upper back is weaker than these, the bar will still find itself more forward because I lack the stability and strength in the upper back to hold the heavier weight on that shelf, to balance it on the back rack, if you will, without me tipping over. But we see how it develops. I may implement a little more low bar squats as well, with me getting more close to my competition goal as well. But to be honest, I will never ignore the high bar because it's so superior to the low bar, if you ask me. I love high bar squats, but because I want to compete in powerlifting, a low bar will be quite more superior when it comes down to achieving heavier numbers. I will use the high bar as a great alternative exercise, though, a tool, if you will. And you just gotta find your style, guys. If I'm being honest, I think I will stay on a more hybrid technique between low and high bar to benefit my style the most. So we'll just adjust my bar placement a little bit, but still try to maintain that upright position with as much extent as possible. But we'll see. I'm excited to see where this gets me. And something I really noticed when writing this new block is that it's quite back dominant, and I really need this. So we'll see where it gets me. Yeah. But that was it for me today, guys. I hope you have a great day, and I catch you on the next one.